Welcome back to those of you who know me, to those of you who don't. My name is Michael DeMarco, and I play the drums. Recently, I got a comment on my Spain playthrough from Benjamin asking me how he can increase the speed of his triple stroke ride cymbal beat. Me to make a video explaining two of the ways that I am able to increase my hand speed and maintain my hand speed. And today I want to go through two different exercises and patterns. One exercise was given to me by another drummer who I met after a show that I saw at a jazz club, and the other is a pattern that I came up with kind of myself as another way of increasing hand speed and being able to maintain those really fast kind of jazz and pseudo Latin grooves for long periods of time. So first, we'll start with the Louis Belson exercises given to me by this other drummer. And the whole premise behind this exercise is quite literally just to increase hand speed. So I will put up some sheet music or a picture of the sheet music with both patterns in between the video so that you can have a reference to what I'm talking about. So with the Belson exercises, you alternate one hand per measure, just like in the sheet, moving through the four main subdivisions: quarter notes, eighth notes, triplets, and sixteenths. So the idea being you're working on your single hand timing and you're able to work on your hand speed at the same time. So we start with quarter notes between each hand, then eighth notes, then triplets, and sixteenths. And I sat down and practiced this for, 5 to 10 minutes every other day, depending on when I had time and when I wanted to sit down and do it. And the whole goal of this is to practice your hand speed, which in turn will allow you to play 16th note grooves on the hi-hat or constant eighth note patterns on the ride cymbal when you're playing something kind of fast and up tempo. And that's the basis of that entire exercise. So I'll play it in three different tempos, and I'm slow to fast, just to kind of give you a reference for how that will sound. And then I would encourage you to try it out for yourself. The second exercise, which is I kind of labeled as hand-to-hand speed and coordination, is similar to the Belsen exercises, but it focuses solely on the fastest subdivision, so in this case 16th notes, and alternating between the two as a 4-3-2 kind of pattern as a means of working on hand speed, but also working on kind of rhythmic coordination and how when you go from 4-3-2 you can switch hands between measures, and it's also you're working in and around some sort of kind of repeated ostinato. In addition to increasing hand speed and coordination, the other goal of these exercises is to make sure that each measure or each kind of single hand motion remains consistent and you're not accenting any of the other beats when you're playing hand to hand. The idea that each note between the hand remains as even as it can be, as opposed to, which is another exercise entirely. If you'd like me to cover more topics like these, please leave a comment down below, or if you'd like me to cover something else, or ask me another question about these types of things, again, please leave a comment down below. I hope you found this information helpful, and hopefully it will help you in your journey to get faster hands.